everyone, my name is Adriana Boyega and I'm a makeup artist here with Boots. Today I'm going to be showing you how to achieve the French girl chic look. This look comprises of a beautiful velvety skin look, gorgeous smoky eye, as well as also a natural lip. I'm going to be showing you how you can create this look for any age. I first went in with the Estée Lauder Advanced Night Repair, which is my favourite to really plump and hydrate the skin. It's packed full of hyaluronic acid. A key part of this look is the velvety skin. To create this, I went in with the Tente d'Or Ultra foundation from Lancôme. This is perfect for that really beautiful, hydrated, velvety looking skin. Now, if you really struggle with under eye circles and darkness, then I'm going in with my favorite products, which are the Bobbi Brown Corrector in Light Bis, which is fantastic to knock back any blue or purple undertones and really brighten the eye. And then I finished off with the Fenty Beauty Bright Fix to really give you that under eye highlight. Next up, I'm going in with the Freestyle Cream Bronzer by Fenty Beauty to softly define and add some definition. I'm applying this to the high points of the face where the sun will catch, such as the forehead, just under the cheekbones and along the jawline as well. I'm creating a soft and defined natural brow by using two products. I'm going in first of all with the Benefit Gimme Brow. I absolutely love the Benefit Gimme Brow because it's a great way to add definition and also add fullness to the brow. One of my pro tips is actually to use it in a back combing motion. That creates texture and also helps to give a really feathery approach and look to the brow. Then to finish off, I'm going in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Pen. This is fantastic because it mimics the appearance of fine hairs and gives a very soft and defined look to the brows. For this look, I'm building up a really gorgeous chocolatey smoky eye. I'm using one of my favorite products for an effortless smoky eye look. These are the Bobbi Brown Longwear Cream Shadow Sticks that I'm using. I'm going in with the shade Taupe, which is a really lovely neutral color. And what's great is that you can apply this all the way from the lower lash line, smoking up to the crease of your eye. I'm now going in with a little bit of definition at the lash line with the Cream Shadow Stick in Bark. I'm also now taking both shades of the Cream Shadow Sticks just under the lash line to create a little bit of depth and balance. I think it's very important to do this because it allows the eyes to look a little bit more open. I'm now going in with the Costa Riche Eye Pencil from MAC. This is a really gorgeous pencil to create a soft definition around the lash line. I've gone inside the waterline as well as on top of the lash line as well. And then I'm going in with some of the darker matte shades in the eyeshadow palette from MAC to redefine the lash line. This is really important if you have hooded eyes or lack lid space because it really helps to open up the eyes and creates really good definition. I've curled the lashes and next I'm going in with the Lancôme Cils Booster XL. This is a fantastic lash primer to really add those full fat lashes into the mix. And then I'm finishing off with the MAC Magic Extension Mascara. This is a brand new mascara that I'm absolutely loving. It makes your lashes look really stretched and fanned out. Now I'm going back to cheeks with a dusting of blusher. I'm going in with the cult classic from Bobbi Brown, the Pot Rouge in Powder Pink. Now for most people, when they think of blusher, they always apply it by smiling on the apples of the cheeks, but I wanted to keep this very modern and apply a little bit higher just above the cheekbones. I've gone in with a colour on the cheeks, very similar to Sam's lip colour. So if you're ever unsure about what colour to choose for blush, just look at the natural tones found in your lip. The finishing touches, I'm going in with a light dusting of powder. I purposefully left powder to the last minute because I feel like there's a massive fear around powder where a lot of people don't like using it at all. But it's actually very important to keep your makeup in place. The key thing is only use powder where needed. First, I'm going in with the number 7 nude lip liner that perfectly matches Sam's lip color. And then I'm finishing off with the Bite Beauty Praline Lipstick. If you're unsure about how to choose the right lipstick for you, choose lip colors that match your natural lip color. And no look is complete without a finishing touch of setting spray. I'm going in with the number 7 Hydroluminous Hydrating Fix Mist, which instantly hydrates your makeup and ensures that it lasts all day. And here's the finished look.